Lo, now for other act upon the stage, childhood and youth, the many an old age, the first son unto phlegm, grandchild to water, unstable, supple, cold and moist's his nature the second, frolic, claims his pedigree from blood and air, for hot and moist is he. The third of fire and color is compassed, vindicative and quarrelsome disposed. The last of earth and heavy melancholy, solid, hating all lightness and all folly. Childhood was clothed in white and green to show his spring was intermixed with some snow, upon his head nature a garland set of primrose, daisy and the violet. Such cold mean flowers the spring puts forth betime, before the sun hath thoroughly heed the clime. His hobby striding did not ride but run, and in his hand an hourglass new begun, in danger every moment of a fall, and when he is broke then ends his life in dull, but if he hold till it have run its last, then may he live out 80 years or past. Next youth came up in gorgeous attire, as that fond age doth most of all desire, his suit of crimson and his scarf of green, his pride in's countenance was quickly seen, garland of roses, pinks and gillyflowers seemed on's head to grow bedewed with showers. His face as fresh as his aurora fair, when blushing she first chins to light the air. No wooden horse, but one of metal tried, he seems to fly or swim, and not to ride. Then prancing on the stage, about he wheels, but as he went death waited at his heels. The next came up in a much graver sort, as one that cared for a good report, his sword by his side, and collar in his eyes, but neither us as yet, for he was wise, of autumn's fruits a basket on his arm, his golden godden's purse, which was his charm. And last of all to act upon this stage leaning upon his staff came up old age, under his arm a sheaf of wheat he bore, and harvest of the best, what needs he more? In's other hand a glass even almost run, thus writ about, this out, then am I done.